In a video message to countries in West Africa that are experiencing Ebola outbreaks, President Obama told residents that they cannot get the disease by sitting next to someone on a bus. But CDC recommendations state that travelers in West Africa who begin to show possible symptoms or people who've experienced a high risk of exposure should avoid public transportation, including buses. And we've also seen large amounts of concern shown regarding potentially infected people traveling on airplanes. My first question is, did the CDC vet this video message before it was released and posted on U.S. Embassy websites? And is it true that a person runs absolutely no risk of contracting Ebola on public transportation, such as a bus?
So, yes, CDC vetted the message, and yes, we believe it's accurate. I think there are two different parts of that equation. The first is, if you're a member of the traveling public and are healthy, should you be worried that you might have gotten it by sitting next to someone? And the answer is no. Second, if you are sick and you may have Ebola, should you get on a bus? And the answer to that is also no. You might become ill. You might have a problem that exposes someone around you. Because the risk is so low, we think there is an extremely low likelihood that anyone who traveled on this plane would have been exposed, but we're putting into place extra margins of safety, and that's why we're contacting everyone who was on that flight.
What sort of treatments will Vincent be receiving, and how is it possible for someone, how going forward, will it be possible to stop people that treated Mr. Duncan from, you know, getting on public transportation?
So the treatment of both of the patients there is as per their treating physicians, and that information has to be from the hospital there. In terms of controlled movement, that's something that we work out with the state and local public health authorities. At this time, we require anyone who may have been exposed to travel by controlled movement only. The healthcare worker number two, who traveled from Ohio on the 13th of October, Monday, should not have traveled, should not have been allowed to travel by plane or any public transport by virtue of the fact that she was in an exposed group. And although she did not report any symptoms and she did not meet the fever threshold of 100.4, she did report at that time that she took her temperature and found it to be 99.5. So by both of those criteria, she should not have been on that plane. I don't think that changes the level of risk of people around her. She did not vomit. She was not bleeding. So the level of risk of people around her would be extremely low. But because of that extra margin of safety, we will be contacting them all.